Welcome all again on another episode of Square Feet on Vishwavahini. Today we are doing a special program to introduce our newly appointed brand ambassador of Dwellings Group. And we are very honored to appoint this special person who helped Sri Lankan businesses in Australia as well as done many things to our Sri Lankan community back in Sri Lanka as well. Highly regarded person, been in the Victorian Parliament for more than 20 years and held number of portfolios over that time period, and also been the Speaker of Victorian Parliament. That is none other than Telmo Languilier. Telmo, aibowan, and welcome on board to the program. And we are honored to have you on board at Dwellings Group and helping and promoting Dwellings brand in Australia as well as internationally. And to start with the discussion, Telmo, now I wanted you to give an introduction to our viewers that things you have been doing and your portfolios, how you come to the country, what is your background, how you become a politician and start supporting to our Sri Lankan community as well.
Thank you, and I do thank you for the kind invitation to be engaged with Dwellings Group and to be its brand ambassador. I'm actually privileged to be able to do that with you too, gentlemen.
We are honored as well, Telmo.
Because, well, first of all, I think some members of our communities, particularly Sri Lankans, would know that I came to this country as a refugee myself many years ago now, from Uruguay, from South America. So I did the jobs that all of us have done, cleaning farms, abattoirs, you name it. Then I had the opportunity given to me by a good policy to enter university, where I did a Bachelor of Arts and in Cultural Studies, Australian Cultural Studies, and I did Physical Education. But ultimately and fundamentally, I have devoted my life to public service, to civil service, to human rights, and to many of those civil and human rights issues that were especially so in the 80s and 90s in Latin America. When I entered Parliament in 1999, I became converted to the cause of Sri Lanka. And I mean the cause of Sri Lanka in terms of the cause and the call for peace, for reconciliation, for harmony, for upholding rule of law and multicultural nature of your community, as you well know. And I've been to Sri Lanka enough times to be able to confirm that. And so I was co-chair of the Friendship Group, Parliamentary Friendship Group for Sri Lanka for possibly about 18 years.
No, that's great.
It's a long time. And that has developed, very importantly for me and my family, if I may say, affection and respect for Sri Lanka and for your community and for the people of Sri Lanka in Sri Lanka, but also for the community here in Australia. And so I'm delighted to join you because I think that what you have undertaken, and we talked about it off camera, you came to the country as students, you had met in Sri Lanka, you came to the great nation like me and the majority of this population with a lot of dreams, and did all the jobs that we have just said we have done. You graduated, you went to Monash University, you had met at Manchester University back in Sri Lanka. You're from Galway, which is, if I might say, my favorite city because I'm a swimmer. And so I love Galway. And you're from Colombo, which I also love, but I have my preferences, if I might say. and so you did all of that, and now you come up with this amazing concept of providing a holistic approach, and importantly, for the relationship between Sri Lanka and Australia and Victoria, it is these sort of efforts and this sort of business enterprise that underpins the strength of the relationship between Australia and Sri Lanka and indeed Victoria. And I said for many years, may I say for many decades, that the time will come when we have to help rebuild Sri Lanka economically and commercially and strengthen these type of links. And we are very honored and privileged as a generation that are able to enjoy that now. And the efforts that you are doing internationally to bring Sri Lankans and Australians, the diaspora here in the country, to bring them together through business investments, whether it's residential, industrial, commercial, is precisely what needs to happen between the two countries.
Yeah.
Because when you do that, both nations benefit. So I see you, if I may, as young men, precisely following through the dream that we had during the difficult times, during the conflict in Sri Lanka, when we said one day we will have to help rebuild Sri Lanka. And so I'm really happy. I'm really happy, and I mean that very privileged and humble by being able to join you to continue to promote this relationship. And now is the time to call on the Sri Lankan community and others to come to you as a company and to work through you, to support each other. Because what you're doing today in this country and the energy that you're putting commercially in Sri Lanka in bringing people together through business, through investments of the nature that we talked about before, is precisely what needs to do to continue to grow the relationship between these two great countries. So I'm really excited about being able to say that we can now do this in peace and in harmony. So I said to you, I think in your office before, and I repeat this, and I say it very, very, very respectfully, but you are and you represent what this nation is about. Two international students who come to this country, who have a dream to put yourselves through education, who work for a range of important Australian companies, and now you're taking this initiative to run with it, and you're taking on the world a bit. And I think it's exciting. And I think there is everything and every reason why the community and the listeners should come to Dwellings, to the Dwellings Group, to work with you, to look for opportunities. And if they want to be in that space of looking for an opportunity, whether it's residential, industrial, commercially, or by way of investment, why not look to your own? And your own means you guys. And whilst I'm not Sri Lankan, I think people know that I have enormous affection for Sri Lanka, and I want to see it succeed, and I want the community to succeed. So I'm very happy to be here with you and to be able to promote this important Dwellings Group.
Thank you, Telmo. Thank you very much for that great introduction. And you've been co-chair of Sri Lanka-Australia Parliamentary Group for more than 18 years and work closely between two nations and building the relationship. That's really helped. And we appreciate your support promoting Dwellings brand, which is originally two Sri Lankans become Australians. Now we are dual citizens. We're working between two countries and trying to see the opportunities for both countries and helping, and your help is really appreciated.
And talking about Sri Lanka, Telmo, I think you have done a number of initiatives when it was affected by tsunami and also during the conflict time period back in Sri Lanka. You have done a lot of social work and worked with the government and done a lot of things in Sri Lanka. So
yes. Look, again, I was very humbled by being a part of the project of the Victorian government under the stewardship of Steve Bragg, the former premier, and John Brumby. And in fact, the current premier, who was then Minister for Health, and I was his right-hand man in the health portfolio, to have been directly engaged in the building of the hospital near your city in Karapitiya. It's a Sri Lanka Victoria Trauma Center. If I might say, the most advanced trauma, multiple trauma center that you have in that country.
That is still
absolutely
managed by the Alfred Hospital, you said, right?
Yes, it's a partnership with the Alfred Hospital. We have visiting doctors and professors from the administration to the doctors, to the nurses, to the clinical staff, to the operating theatres. They all are constantly engaged with us in Victoria. I visited the hospital many times. It's very functioning, it's very powerful. It provides a great service to Sri Lanka. But also very importantly, it helps us do a lot of good work in Victoria. So there is a clear example, measurable example of friendship, where at a time of most need, because you had post-tsunami, and during the course of the conflict, in a lot of instances, you have multiple cases of trauma, and the question then becomes, how do we deal with it? What do we do when we've got five operating theaters, but 25, 30 or 50 people outside requiring clinical, surgical, operating theater? How do we deal with that? And so the Alfred Hospital is arguably the most advanced in the world and developed a very good model and system of dealing with multiple trauma. So the Sri Lankan hospital, that hospital is an amazing hospital. And I've been there with the administration, with the doctors, with the Australian practitioners who work arm in arm with the Sri Lankans. And I'm very privileged to have been directly involved in that project. And I saw it from the time when there was nothing. An empty block of land that later turned into a hospital with a number of operating theaters, with a serious number of beds and staff and functioning well. So that was one important project directly involved. And of course, one develops a lot of affection, love for it, and you want it to succeed. Then of course, during the course of the conflict, Australia and Victoria did not just projects in the south, which we did in terms of the hospital, in terms of building properties as well, which I visited for a lot of those families, called the Bilateral project or housing project. But we also undertook an important initiative in the north, near Jeffna, a fishing village, where we built a multi-purpose building, where we, for all sorts of, for community activities, for social engagement, for religious practices and faith for the community. But in addition to that, the provision of fishing vessels of significance, in the order of 250 or 300, thereabouts, which at the time of the conflict provided important economic creation, wealth creation for those families in the north, in Jeffna. So we are able to go to the totality of the country and say that where we could, during difficult times, whether it's post-tsunami, during the conflict, which we're so glad it ended, we're able to be engaged in that. In addition to that, the community might not be aware that through Life Saving Victoria, we also have done most of the training for lifesavers or lifeguards throughout Sri Lanka, whether it's in hotels, whether it's in rivers, in lakes or the ocean. There is a joint project being run from Victoria. It's an amazingly successful program which trains lifeguards and trains Sri Lankans how to deal with water. Because you would be aware that Sri Lanka, not sure about the numbers today, but you used to lose about 2,500 lives every year through drownings. And the best defense for that was to teach them how to swim and to train the lifeguards. So if you go to international hotels all around the coast in Sri Lanka, you will see, interestingly, that the lifeguards in a lot of those places wear the colors that we wear, like lifeguard here from the
Similar Australia. To Australia.
Similar, the same as Australia. Yeah. And so we provide the training, we provide where we can the equipment. These are important projects at a grassroots level. And I come back to what you do. What you do is precisely the same.
Exactly.
We want Sri Lankans to own their homes, whether it's here or whether it's there. To live in those homes, because that's the best way of looking after themselves when they become older persons, to actually say, this is my home, whether it's in Sri Lanka or whether it's in Australia, to be able to make that facilitation. And importantly, I repeat, I'm glad that I joined a group of people that are trusted and respected. You guys are trusted and respected, and that is worth a lot in relationship terms, in value terms, trust and respect. People will know that they can come to you, and I'd be delighted to help where I can to assist in promoting this important group, which I think is one of the many good initiatives that this community has that will continue to strengthen the relationship between the two great nations.
Yeah, and actually, just want to add a couple of points to your talk, because Australia has been one of the world number one multicultural cities. So many cultures mixed together, succeeded in their ventures, coming from outside. As your original story, you came here as a refugee and gone through the path of education, you know, building up families and setting up businesses. Orchestrating that is a huge thing, and this is the world, that's why most diverse city in the world, and it's most livable city for last 7-8 years.
Yes.
And now we started business, we are trying to connecting Australia into Sri Lanka and rest of the world, and making benefits for both countries. And you join now promoting our brand, which is, we are honored and we're really glad that this is happening. And together we are much stronger. That's the motto we are following, so we can go out to broader markets, broader audience, and expand our business. And Telmo, one more thing, when we discussed before, you were saying that you are in the process of organizing a platform to connect Australian business into Sri Lanka. Let's talk about that. That's important, I think.
Well, the answer is yes, and this is the first time that I talk about it publicly. So it's good for us, but it's good for this important.
So we are glad that we are talking on our program.
Look, without getting into the international politics and geopolitical developments that exist at the moment, that everyone and your audience certainly watches on television and listens to in the news. I think first I'll say this. I believe that whilst there is a lot of conflict going on between Australia and other countries, it presents a great opportunity for Australia and Sri Lanka to become closer friends and to strengthen and to solidify its partnership and its friendship. We both countries of the Commonwealth, we both have English, in Sri Lanka predominantly, but importantly English. We both have the British tradition in the sense of the judiciary, rule of law, a parliament that functions like ours and vice versa. I'm reminded of my many visits to the parliament, and I could relate to the decisions being made by the chair or the speaker. We speak English, we belong to the Commonwealth, we respect the rule of law and freedoms that both nations want to uphold. We play cricket, we understand each other through sports. And whilst there is conflict around us, I think it's a good opportunity, and it's an important opportunity to say, well, who are the historical friends that I've always had? And Sri Lanka, Australia are precisely in that position. And as you know well, Sri Lanka is geographically positioned in a wonderful region of growth. You're miles away from India, one of the biggest markets, another important democracy similar to our tradition. And so this is a great opportunity for us to become closer, to see where we can find space of common interests in business, in sports, in between hospitals, in the general relationship between the two countries. So because of my association with Sri Lanka and my may I say, understanding of Sri Lankan politics to some extent, which I follow quite regularly, I have embarked upon working with the federal opposition to develop the architecture for the future relationship that I will, as a member of my own party, work through internally. So when and if, and I don't want to get into party politics, but I think everybody would know that I'm a Labour man, when and if Labour wins in Canberra, we have a good, solid framework where we can do more. And we need to identify those areas now. What can we do more? I did this in Latin America. I think we can double the number of students in both directions. visitors between the two countries. I think we should double the number of visitors. The number of visitors, particularly those associated to families who are here. I think we should aim to doubling our trade between the two countries. And there is important trade and relationships that we can grow. The investments of taking your company with important Australian businesses, if I may mention, like Metricon, is a great initiative. And other developers, I think we need to bring universities closer. I think we need to look at universities that are similar to each other, where they can work better together, much more aggressively. But essentially, the message would have to be that this is a great time for Sri Lanka and Australia to double its relationship in everything we do together. We are historical friends, we're going in the same direction, we reaffirm the important values of democracy, rule of law, freedoms. We must underpin that with real things in every possible relationship that can do. And I think you guys, and may I say myself too now, Dwelling Group is in a great position to be able to assist in doing that. And so I'll be working together with yourselves and other friends in the Sri Lankan community. And of course, we'll consult with the relevant authorities to look at having a very strong framework for a potential future government on my side of politics with respect. And I think both parties work very well, by the way, with Sri Lanka. So it's not a question of one or the other. I think both recognize that the relationship is very important, but I belong to one, and my obligation is to try and work within that framework. And I'll be looking at doing everything we can to double everything we do between the two countries.
So that's really great. Actually, even at Dwelling Group, now you are part of it. We are happy to be part of that initiative and be part of the gateway and connecting businesses from Sri Lanka to Australia and vice versa. So which is a great opportunity for all of us, Sri Lankans as well as Australians, which is great. Time is running out, Telmo, but we have a lot of things to talk about. But you are very connected in South American community, and this is an initiative we're going to talk to a lot of people. And also, you are the International Relations Director for Melbourne Victory, which is another great point to make here. Can you a little bit elaborate on what you're doing on those aspects?
I believe, and I think I mentioned to you that academically I had studied sports and physical education. I believe that there is an important role for sports diplomacy. And the sports, like the arts, a lot of the times they go before the politics and the international relations in the more formal sense. So through sports, I think we can do a lot in terms of bringing communities together, including, which is football, otherwise known in this country as soccer, but I'm old fashioned and I call it football, including with Sri Lanka incident. It's a growing sport. And there are fantastic opportunities coming up now with the World Cup for Australia and New Zealand through women to position through sports a lot of the business and the investments, because millions of people will come here and we will be watched by the world in football terms. And so there are lots of opportunities through sports for businesses and other sports and governments to take in the good sense, good advantage of that for the future. So I do international relations with my club. I'm privileged to be able to work with my club. Victor is my club, has always been my club. And when I retired from Parliament, Melbourne Victory offered me a great opportunity. And coming from Latin America and coming from Uruguay, which is a very small country, but a big country in football terms. You would be aware, if I might say to my Latin American friends from other countries who might listen, Uruguay won 2 World Cups, 2 Olympic gold medals. My team has won 2 World Cups, individual teams, and in the arguably the toughest cup for the Latin Americans, which is what we call the Copa America, which is all the Latin American countries, highly fought for. Uruguay has won 16 Copa Americas.
Wow. Similar to cricket in Sri Lanka.
Yes, indeed. We punch well above our weight. That's the truth. Argentina won 15 and Brazil 9. So put this in context. So I come from a nation of football. I love the sports. And what we will try and do, which I think is won't be that difficult, is to bring these communities together too. Because we are not dissimilar. We are family-oriented people. We believe in hard work and hard studying or education, because it's education that transforms our lives, in your case, in my case. I quote Nelson Mandela when he was in Robben Island, and Mandela writes, before the end of apartheid, the most powerful weapon that we can give a young man or a young woman is education, to transform themselves, their families, their community, and their nation. Now, this is absolutely applicable to Sri Lanka.
Correct.
Because you know well that Sri Lanka invests per capita the most in the region. It believes in education, in the transformative power of education, of individuals like us, our families, but indeed the nation. So we can do a lot of good things. Our families have the same values. Why do I feel so comfortable amongst Sri Lankans? Because we have the same values.
Okay.
We feel the same. And I love the food as well. So it's an added component. So there are similar communities who came to the country like us with the same dreams, who should pursue good education, good employment, and good housing. And they should do it through people that they can trust, and people who are trusted and who are reliable. And I think you are that group, and that's why I'm very honestly very happy to join the Dwellings group.
Thank you very much, Telmo. And for our audience, we are glad and very happy to announce that Telmo is part of Dwellings group team now. And you can contact Telmo on his email telmo@dwellingsgroup.com.au at any time. And also you can call us, our office, and connect to Telmo if you need to connect with Telmo for anything. And he'll be a great asset in promoting and working together to get our brand to expand the brand to the rest of the world and within the other communities that we want to expand. And unfortunately, time is running out, so we will finish our program. But Telmo is part of our dueling stream, so he'll be connecting and joining similar programs again and again. And you can meet him on all Dwellings group events and future promotions, and he'll be part of the team. And thank you for helping Sri Lankan businesses in Australia. You've been helping our nation for many, many years in Parliament and beyond Parliament politics as well. And as a Sri Lankan, as a nation, we all thank you for helping Sri Lanka in very difficult times as well. And also, finally, I must mention Don Susanta Katugambala. He's also working together with Dwellings Group as a one-stop shop. We take care of migration, legal, conveyancing, finance, and he orchestrated this relationship with Telmo and Dwellings Group. I must thank him as well. He's been helping our clients in migration matters, so you can contact Telmo and our team to connect to Susanta as well and his support as well. And we'll come back on another episode, and we'll close this program now. Thank you so much. Thank you for being with us. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.